Hi friends, welcome to my channel, and if you're already subscribed, thank you and welcome back. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can easily make homemade pizza in a pan at home. If you don't have an oven, you don't need to worry because this recipe doesn't require an oven. So let's get started with the recipe. My go-to topping for a pizza is corn, bell peppers, onions and chicken. That's what I like. If I am in a hurry or in a mood for pizza, that's my go-to topping. So I've used that in this recipe, but you can definitely switch with whatever ingredients you like. Write down in the comments below what ingredients you like. I would really like to taste that and make a recipe out of it if you guys want. So for this, I have used about a quarter cup of corn, quarter cup of bell peppers, quarter cup of onions, and about a quarter cup, which is equivalent to 200 grams of chicken in small pieces. To that, add quarter teaspoon of oregano and quarter teaspoon of black pepper powder. I didn't add salt here because I'm adding 1 teaspoon of my homemade pizza and pasta sauce, which already has seasoning in it, so I didn't. Plus I'm going to add cheese also, which is also salted. After adding the sauce, about a teaspoon of sauce, toss it around in the pan until the sauce coats all the vegetables and the chicken. Then take that aside and let it cool. Now for making the dough or the base for the pizza, you can definitely buy a pizza base if you don't want to, but here I have made my own homemade yeast because it was a lockdown was going on in our area, I'm pretty sure everywhere in the world, and I couldn't get hold of yeast, so I made yeast myself. If you want, I can show you guys the process of making it. Write down in the comments if you want me to show. I have used about a cup of flour, which will give me 2 big pizza bases. But if you want a small pizza, or if you are doing a pizza party, definitely 2 small pizzas. So it will be sufficient for 4 pizzas. In total, I have used here 1.5 cup of flour. So 1 cup for the each to feed on, and then half a cup for you to roll the dough and everything in between, so 1.5 cup in total. I divided this amount of dough into 2 portions and then rolled out one of the portion, like you when you make roti or chapati, like that. Since I like thin crust pizzas, which is usually better for when you're doing in a pan, as you don't have heat from the top like in an oven, it's better to do thin crust pizzas, otherwise the dough might not cook properly. But if you want, I can try making a thick crust or a cheese filled crust. Definitely write it in the comments. So roll the pizza about a inch to 1.5 inches thick. Then put a pan on low heat, extremely low heat, like on simmer, as low as your gas can go or your hob can go, and put the pizza base. We need to cook one side of the pizza base about 40% so that the pizza sauce and the toppings that we'll add doesn't make the pizza base soggy. using a spoon, using a fork, make some holes into the pizza base so that the whatever air it creates, as it got yeast, its tendency is to rise and make the dough fluffy, and we need to prevent that. We don't want a bulky dough like a puri. Cook the pizza base on one side for 1 minute on low heat, then turn it and then again dock it with using a fork and cook it for 1 minute again. Now turn the gas off or the hob off. We don't need to cook the pizza right now, and start layering the pizza sauce and the topping. I'm using about 2 tablespoons of sauce here. When you're applying the sauce, make sure try to keep a rim around the or a lip around the pizza base. It will help the pizza to hold better. Don't push all the sauce along its side. After the sauce layer, put about a handful of grated cheese. I'm using mozzarella cheese, a layer of that. It will help the toppings to stick to the sauce. If you don't add cheese here, the toppings might fall. Now add as much toppings as you want in a pizza, but I would prefer not to add too much. Last, cover the toppings with again the rest of the cheese. I'm using about a quarter cup of grated mozzarella or pizza cheese. Then finally sprinkle some black pepper. I like heat, that's why I'm adding black pepper, but you can definitely skip that. Now if you want, you can add a little bit of pizza seasoning. That is optional. Cover it with a lid. Make sure that the whole of the pizza is covered inside the lid. Then turn the gas on or the hob on. First 2 minutes on medium heat. Then 10 minutes on low heat. The lowest your gas can go. After 10 minutes, don't try to lift the lid before the time is over. After 10 minutes, lift the lid and you can see my pizza is bubbling and it's as good as you can get on like in Domino's or Pizza Hut. I also cut my hand, so give a like for that. Literally, the blood has went into making this recipe. So please a like and a share for that. So after 15 minutes, all jokes aside, after 15 minutes, pull the pizza out of the pan. And then cut it into as many portions as you want. Don't try to cut it with a knife, as you will see, it doesn't work properly. It's better to use a scissor or a pizza wheel. I don't have a pizza wheel, so I'm going to use scissors here. use scissors and cut the pizza into whatever portions you like. Or if you're eating alone, keep the whole pizza for yourself. I don't judge. It's your house, your kitchen, your rules. See, the crust of the pizza is really crispy. This pizza is better than the pizza you will find in the market, like in pizza chains, because you know what you have put in it and everything is from your home. So I really hope you like this video. Please leave a like, subscribe and share this video with your friends and family, and I'll see you guys. Bye.